Hello everyone, welcome to Engineered Learnings. Engineered Learnings has been created as an effort to help and reach out to all the engineering students, aspirants and professionals out there with the basic understanding and the crux of the topics important for placements, vivas, semesters, competitive examinations and all types of interviews. So let's go to today's topic. Used in an industry. This video has been requested by one of our subscribers and that's why we have brought this topic into light. It's very important for semesters, placements, vivas, interviews. The types of pumps, where and when are they used, and the pumps in series and parallel. When do we need series pumps, when do we need parallel pumps. Apart from the two types of pumps that are conventional, that is centrifugal pump and positive displacement pump, we have also discussed the third kind. To have a clear view, watch the video till the end. So let's start. So basically we have covered three types of pumps in this video. That is, first of all, positive displacement pump, positive displacement. Second is centrifugal pump or impeller pump. And third, last but not the least, open pump. It also falls in a category of positive displacement pump, but how it is different, we will talk about that. So, talking of these three types of pumps, first of all, let's talk about positive displacement pump. How is it different from impeller pump? So, positive displacement pump is a pump that behaves in such a way that it takes a certain amount of volume, compresses it, and sends it to a higher pressure zone after a certain point of time. So it takes in some volume, it compresses it over a certain period of time, and then discharges it. So if you observe the discharge flow rate, it will be something like this over time. Discharge flow rate will be something like this over time. For a certain time, it does not release anything, and then it keeps on releasing. So it's like a pulse type arrangement in the discharge line, if you see, because it takes in some volume, it takes in some time to compress that, and then it sends it at a very high pressure. So positive displacement pump is generally used when the pressure requirement is high, that is very high discharge head is required, and the capacity is not that high, it is low. That is, we do not need a very high capacity pump. If we need that, we need to have a constant flow. Now, positive displacement pumps can also have constant flows by connecting two pumps in series, such that when one pump suffers this lag, that is the time period when it compresses, the other pump serves its discharge. So it will be something like this, a constant line. If we use the pumps working together, if we use two positive displacement pumps connected with one another, such that when one pump compresses, the other pump discharges. So it will be maintaining something like this. But for a very high capacity, a positive displacement pump can never be used. For a very high capacity, a constant flow is required. For a very high volume, then we need to use an impeller pump or a centrifugal pump. For positive displacement pump is used when the pressure head to be generated is very high, that is the discharge pressure that is required is very high, and also when the viscosity of the liquid is high. For highly viscous liquids, positive displacement pumps should be used. Impeller pumps should be avoided, and we will come to the mechanism of action to prove why positive displacement pump is used at all for high viscous liquid. Now, you see, let us discuss the positive displacement pump in details. So the positive displacement pump has basically two types under itself. One is the reciprocating type. Another is the rotary type. Now the reciprocating type is a piston cylinder arrangement. This is the piston that first takes in the feed at a low pressure, creating a vacuum. First, when it moves out, it tries to create a vacuum, a low pressure zone here. The fluid comes in, at a lower pressure. When it comes in at a lower pressure, it pushes it back, trying to create a high pressure zone, and finally releases it at a higher pressure. A pump's job is to take in from a lower pressure zone and to release it at a higher pressure zone. That is what it does. It increases the pressure and discharges it to a higher pressure. That is, the pump takes in inlet at a lower pressure and discharges it after compressing the piston. The element compresses this entire thing and discharges it at a very high pressure. Now, you can see that this is an arrangement which will take in the volume at one point of time where there will be no discharge. After that, it will tend to compress it, and slowly the discharge rate increases, and then it again falls and again passes through a constant period. Now, this connected to a series, as I was already telling you, this connected to a series, another positive displacement reciprocating pump. What it happens is, when this suffers the downstroke, this suffers the upstroke. So the fluid is dragged in at low pressure when this discharges it. And then when this moves up and tries to suck in the fluid at low pressure, this goes down and discharges it. So the discharge is constant. If we mix the two discharges and send it, then the discharge is constant. That is, it does not change. If we use two reciprocating pumps in series, or two positive displacement pumps working in series with each other, that is, in connection with each other. Now, for reciprocating pumps, this is my working principle. For rotary pumps, what happens is, supposedly this is a vessel. Supposedly rotary pumps can be divided into rotary lobe, gear pump, peristaltic pump, very commonly used peristaltic pump, very commonly used term in industry, and lastly screw pump. All of this functions in a similar way that for a rotary lobe, let us explain, this is the lobe, this sucks in the fluid at low pressure, and then the lobe presses the fluid due to its rotary action, presses the fluid against the wall to create a high pressure. The fluid travels through a low pressure zone to a high pressure zone and then gets discharged at a high pressure. So this is the work of a rotary lobe. Similarly, for a screw pump, there is nothing but a barrel and a screw. I'm drawing the screw like this for the moment, and maybe twin screws are often used. So the two screws, what they do, they move against one another, and the fluid is trapped somewhere between the wall and the screw, and the fluid is pressurized as the screw moves forward. The fluid is pressurized against the inner surface of the wall, and finally, at a low pressure, it is taken in, at a high pressure, it is discharged. Now, you will get the answer why viscosity high is preferred. Now, if the viscosity high is preferred, there is no way that this fluid will come back to the pressure low zone. But if the viscosity is low, for a low viscosity fluid, there is a tendency of the backflow of the fluid to the other section of the screw and inside wall. So for high viscous liquid, intentionally it is done to prevent, it is compressed in a positive displacement pump, because for a high viscous liquid, the backflow tendency decreases, which is a requirement in positive displacement pumps. So, rotary screw is done. Similarly, for a gear arrangement, we know that this gear will have teeth, and these teeth, not drawing the gear properly here, but these teeth will contain the liquid. So, the teeth has entrapped the liquid in between the teeth and the inside of the wall, which pressurizes the fluid from a low pressure zone to a high pressure zone. So it all acts in the same way. For peristaltic pump, it is something like this. If we draw for peristaltic pump, it is some arrangement like this. A pipe goes, and the pipe is compressed or constrained at certain points by almost a gear arrangement. Constricted, creating a high pressure zone pressing against the walls. It is a tubular element, and the fluid moves forward from a low pressure zone to a high pressure zone due to contractions created by the blades. Against pressing the tube against the wall and creating the fluid to move from a low pressure zone to a high pressure zone. This is the peristaltic pump. This is a peristaltic pump. Creating a muscular contraction through the valve, almost like our blood vessels, the valves, the tubes through which the fluid flows. Creating a constriction, a contraction, because of which the fluid gains high pressure and moves towards the high pressure zone. So this is the action of a peristaltic pump. All of this acts in a certain way, both the reciprocating and the rotary. Takes in the fluid, keeps it for some time, tries to press, tries to create generate pressure, and then releases it at a high pressure. So it is discharging at some point of time and then being static at some point of time. And meanwhile, it is compressing the entire thing. And it is used for high viscosity fluid and high discharge pressure generation fluid, where you need a high discharge pressure generation and low capacity. Now, talking of impeller pumps. Now, what are impeller pumps? Impeller, as we already know, this is a centrifugal pump. This is an involute, and the fluid enters from here. Now, as soon as the fluid enters from here, the pump, the impeller blades, give it a kinetic energy. Due to the gain in kinetic energy, it is thrown towards the periphery. When it is thrown towards the periphery, it gains a very high velocity. And as it proceeds, as the blade's area increases, the velocity keeps on decreasing, and at this point of time, at the periphery, the velocity is lowered, that is, it is choked, and the fluid is kept stagnant, so it loses its kinetic energy, and the kinetic energy gets converted into pressure energy. That is, at the periphery, my pressure energy increases. My pressure energy increases by decreasing the kinetic energy that is given by the pump. So it is basically a constant flow arrangement. So you give the fluid, it is thrown, it is choked, it is gaining velocity. Give the fluid, it is thrown, it is choked, it is creating velocity. So it is a constant procedure at a high capacity. High capacity. But not a very high pressure. Not a very high pressure, discharge pressure. If you need a very high discharge pressure, then comes the concept of pumps in series. If you need a very high discharge pressure, what would you opt for? You would opt for when the pressure requirement and the capacity requirement both are high, supposedly, you will use centrifugal pumps in series. Because you already get a high capacity, and with that, the exit of one pump serves as the entry for the other. So ultimately, you get a high pressure head by keeping multiple centrifugal pumps in series. For low viscosity liquids, you need to go for positive displacement pump. But supposedly, you need a high capacity pump as well. Along with low viscosity, you need a high pressure and high capacity. Now, these two, low viscosity and high pressure, are served by positive displacement pump, but you do not get a high capacity in a positive displacement pump. So what you can do is, you can keep multiple pumps in, positive displacement pumps in series, in parallel. And even if you need to increase the capacity, you can keep centrifugal pumps in parallel as well. So what happens is, this is a pump, this is a pump, this is a pump. These three pumps take entries, and finally the exit combines. So the three capacities add up, C1, C2, and C3, add up to give C1 plus C2 plus C3 as my total capacity of a pump in parallel. So if you have to increase the capacity, you will have to go for parallel arrangement. And if you have to increase the pressure head, you will have to go for a series arrangement of pumps. So having said parallel and series arrangement, now going to the last type of pump, that is our open pumps, the third category. It is almost a type of screw arrangement that we have discussed in positive displacement pump already. It is basically a screw that is rising in height, that is something like this, that is maintaining an angle of theta or alpha with the horizontal ground. So what happens is, the fluid is trapped in between the screws, and as the screw rises up against gravity, the fluid also has blood. It is used in open sources, that is, open sources and open discharge points, open to atmosphere. And why so? Because supposedly in rainy seasons, if it rains heavily, it may happen so some amount of water will get mixed with oil if it is used in an oil refinery. If there we employ a centrifugal pump to discharge that oil from lower pressure to higher pressure, we know centrifugal pump is one of the best mixers of the world. So the oil and water will get mixed with each other and will form emulsion. So that will be a problem associated with centrifugal pump. So, to avoid that, we need to keep a provision where there can occur no mixing. So, if debris or coconut shells or any type of impurities, that is suspected impurities are present in the source, it can be easily transferred from a lower pressure to higher pressure, avoiding mixing. So, open pumps, open sources. Thus, Archimedean screw, this is the only type of open pump and is used readily in oil refineries where there is no shed. The rain may pour on the oil and the oil may float on water, and thereafter you cannot use a centrifugal pump. You cannot use a positive displacement pump because they will cause a mixing. Only pump you can use is a screw fluid arrangement wherein you are sending it from a low pressure zone to a high pressure zone using an Archimedean screw. That is the type of open pump where we transfer from open sources. So having said this, the industries that we use in centrifugal pump is generally, as we have already mentioned, for high capacity, centrifugal pump for high capacity, positive displacement for high pressure, high viscosity liquids, centrifugal for low viscosity, and finally open pumps for open sources, mixing is avoided. So that is it. Thomas pumps are used in polymer industry, in oil industry, as and when required. If you need to know more, you will have to refer to books about chemical technology, about fluid mechanics. That's it for today. If you like our work, share, like, and subscribe to our page. Thank you.